It's a writing challenge, critical versus creative, today on The Right Focus. It's April 8th, and I'm still at Sketching Ideas. A lot of scattered little notes today. I'm paying bills, so no serious concentration on writing. It's the first week, and I vowed years ago to have my bill paying for the month over before the 10th. That comes before writing. It's a job I hate. But I am blessed because I can pay everything I am obligated to. Thank God. I'm finishing the post from the day before about lessons I needed to learn. Critical versus creative, writing nonfiction versus fiction, and each book that is vastly different from the ones before. Tomorrow, I start pushing for 5,000 words this week. I don't anticipate a word-filled weekend. In 2018, I published The Key to Secrets on schedule in mid-January. The hardest part of that book was keeping track of the murder clues. Checked the box for the first MA leave for the year. Next up would be my second book, An Itty Runes. I would be refreshing an old manuscript. Easy peasy? Nope. Trouble reared its ugly head again. The Itty Runes novel wouldn't come together. When things don't work out, turn to the next date. I thought that was the only lesson that I needed to learn. Wrong. I switched to the third book in the plan, the next Remy Black, another refresh of an old manuscript. Very little to do. Easy peasy. I just had to make it align with what I had developed in Weave a Wizardry Web. I had a printed out manuscript, and I wrote it out manuscript, and I wrote the revisions and corrections there, then transferred them to computer. Sing a graveyard song flew toward publication. I didn't learn the right lesson, though. I returned to the Itty Runes and stumbled again. That old manuscript wouldn't come together. It's one of the earliest novels that I wrote. Something was particularly wrong with it. I trashed what I had on computer and worked out new scenes with pen and paper. I started a third time, got 50 pages in, and stumbled again. Back to handwriting. Another 30 pages or so. At least the story was moving along. On paper, Winter Sorcery took unexpected turns, morphing into a richer, deeper story than the original was. I had the same arc, but completely different scenes and details in the way I achieved that arc. Winter Sorcery was also running shorter than the other Itty Runes books, but every time I added in details, it felt artificially padded, so those came back out. Between a mix of handwriting and typing, I finished Winter Sorcery and published the day before the spring equinox, barely in winter. Here's what I should have learned with both of these books. The creative ideas happen for me with pen and paper. On computer, I don't let the words flow on and on. I back up and correct. That's critical brain controlling the creative brain. When I'm on paper, I just let the words flow. I'm a fast typist, but I'm faster writing by hand. The words can pour like a river in flood. Some people use dictation software for their creative flow. Then they return and correct. This separates the creative critical. Lesson 29. Next on the list was the next MA Lee, The Key for Spies. I started up on computer and fell into the same problems as before. When the struggling happened, I decided to work on Think Like a Pro, updating and revising. I switched back and forth between the two books. I couldn't figure out why the non-book poured out on the computer, but the fiction book wouldn't. Still slogging through Key for Spies. I hadn't even reached 100 good pages. I finished the nonfiction book, decided to do a planner, dealt with layout issues, finished it, published Think Pro, a planner for writers, decided to do 204 Lifestyle, another planner, and still struggled with Key for Spies. Now I'm into late October. I had changed a character from secondary to a subprime at the end of August, and ideas did flow for that character, but I still struggled getting to the back three quarters and the end. I was seriously behind my goals. Three nonfiction books and still under 100 pages for Key for Spies. Lots of ideas, but very little written. Turning sentences into paragraphs, into scenes, into chapters was a huge slog. I belatedly comprehended, for I already knew, brain that is easier than the creative brain needed for fiction. Lesson 30. The only creative part of nonfiction is the planning and and the sentence craft parts. For Kiefer Spies, I decided to gut all of the draft that I had. I started on a day when the internet was down. My laptop was acting up, and I had to work with pen and paper. 25 great pages. On the next day, I transferred them to the computer and tried to write more. Nope, nothing doing. The next day was a long drive. 4 hours in the back seat of a car. I took a notebook, wound up with close to 50 pages. I didn't touch the laptop again until I had the book in a completed rough shape. New characters had entered the story. New action scenes wrote themselves while I watched in amazement. The book hit the mark of 98,000 words when I finally transferred it to computer. All the while, distractions occurred, commitments and obligations tugged me away from writing, yet the novel poured out every time I managed to sit down with pen and paper. I learned that nonfiction is logical and thus critical brain more suited to my computer-based writing. Fiction, for me, needs the permission to scribble, zoom through words, scratch out, restart, and rush like a torrent. You know, messy creativity. The next book, The Key with Hearts, was 5 days. That's 35 days, sketching, rough shape, draft, revisions, proofreading, corrections. I'm sticking with pen and paper for creative fiction. I learned my lesson. It just took me a couple of years to know that some writing is critical, and fiction writing starts creative. I know, I'm not the brightest bulb in the socket. What inspirational quote did I read today before I started all of my teeny tiny little sticky notes? Well, it's the most famous quotation by an unknown writer. Writers rewrite. I closed with Samuel Johnson. A writer only begins a book, a reader finished. Thanks for listening to The Write Focus, a podcast for writers at all levels, hosted by M.A. Lee, with assistance from Remy Black and Edie Ruins, all from Writers, Inc. Books. Our focus is productivity, process, craft, and tools. Show notes for this and other episodes can be found on thewritefocus.blogspot.com. Write to us at winkbooks@aol.com. Our podcast episodes are running short this month, but usually they last as long as it takes to fix a quick dinner, drive a short commute, or take a brisk walk. Daily in April, we're bookcasting Write a Book in a Month by Remy Black, 2 in the trilogy Inspiration for Writers, copyright 2020. Take lessons from today's episode and write on. It's a writing challenge, critical versus creative, today on The Write Focus. It's April 8th, and I'm still at sketching ideas. A lot of scattered little notes today. I'm paying bills, so no serious concentration on writing. It's the first week, and I vowed years ago to have my bill paying for the month over before the 10th. That comes before writing. It's a job I hate, but I am blessed.